Okay, it's my life in Thailand, my vlog, and this is number four. February the 1st to the 10th. So that's what's been happening. Well, first thing, there's such a good feeling at work when clients return. I had a girl come in 15 years of age. She stopped about 2 years ago because her aunt felt that she needed to focus more on maths and science. Now she's come back. Her English is dreadful, of course, but it gave me a warm glow to know that they come back knowing that they're going to get value for money. Staying with teaching, I've been focusing quite a great deal on these adolescents sharing their feelings, and we spent a lesson a couple of weeks back, and it became clear that the concept of loving yourself first before you can love others was sadly lacking in at least four of them. So I've now got to start to shift focus on gratitude journals to try and lift their spirits. Their parents are knocking shit out of them with this obsession about homework and no fun in their lives whatsoever. And they feel very, very poor. Well, they have very low esteem. What next? Right, let's move on to movies. I've seen a bunch of movies in those 10 days. I saw Lynn Ramsey's Red Road. It's a great movie about surveillance and revenge. Two movies that are up for Oscars next month. Sorry, this month. The Post. That's about the newspaper, The Washington Post, and its attempts to tell the truth about the Vietnam War and the Nixon government trying to suppress the freedom of information. Great performances by Hanks and Meryl Streep. Roman J. Israel Esquire, this is Denzel Washington's new movie. He's sort of in the law business. He is a lawyer, but he's second string, and it's a tale about how, in his determination to be heard, eventually has to compromise all his philosophy and his beliefs for a sake of a little bit of cash. 52 Pickup, 1986, is a nice little film with Roy Snyder, and he basically is getting blackmailed. There's not a lot to it, but it moves along sharply. And now let's move on. What else have I been into in those 10 days? Well, I started Indiams on Instagram. I've been using OneCut so I can now add videos, add pictures to videos. What else? Gary V has been on daily. This man really inspires me. I had a good look at my Google Analytics. The house is depressing me. The light in the house late afternoon is such that I can hardly see with clarity the photos in my photograph albums. What's happening here in Thailand? Well, there's been a clampdown on pro-democracy activists by the junta in Bangkok. No surprises there. A harrowing tale by a doctor in Paris about the number of Thai doctors that are whitening people's penises because of vanity and the dangers of this. Can you believe this? And what else? Oh, I also watched the movie Swimming with Sharks. I've made a video on that. I had a good look at BBC Learning English Online. They've got some fantastic videos integrating images with audio. I thoroughly recommend you take a look at that if you want to improve your English. Vlog ideas. Parents dancing around the truth and not being straight with their kids. Example, I have one student who didn't come for a couple of lessons and ended up having to look after the baby because her parents were being selfish. It was all a facade as they tried to hint that it was because I put the prices up. That girl's actually stopped. And I also just put together a video on parents, a job for life, and with no training and education. So that's probably about it for this set. Okay.